Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more of the Messenger. In the last episode, we explored the catacombs and we bought some upgrades and shit. Well, I still have 268. Whoop. Maybe it didn't save what I bought because I didn't actually leave the. I didn't actually leave the room and touch the checkpoint after I bought that in the last episode. There we go, now it's saved. Anyway, let's fight the boss.
Oh no, it's the Necromancer! And with this army of undead, everyone will soon fear the mighty Ruxton! What now? We have a visitor. I don't have time for visitors! Well, he seems to have time for you. Oh great, just when you think you get to play with your evil lab. Do I have to remind you who's in charge here? Now say something threatening and try not to embarrass us like you did last time. No, I've been practicing. Watch this.
Whoa, he's gonna land. What? Oh my gosh! He's a little shorty.
Ahem! Who dares enter my lair? Uh-oh, is that the messenger?
Looks like it.
What do we do?
Steal the scroll, of course.
Good plan. En garde! Face the mighty might of Ruxton the Great!
Ugh, great. Great, Ruxton the Great. My god, this music's crazy. Wait! Wanna do something where I can actually- What are you doing? Oh my god, what is this Dr. Wily bullshit? This is so weird.
Ow!
No, I keep pushing the wrong button, man. Is that the button that it is on Switch? Oh, you're blinking red already. You ain't shit, man.
Ow!
Did that actually work there? I think I actually did hit that projectile. Can I hit these projectiles? Yeah, I can. Okay, I'm not going to anymore though because I'm gonna die if I do. Get in the thing, thank you.
Ow!
Oh my god, dude, would you die already? Please? Okay, there we go. Woo! That was close. We almost had our first death there because I was being a chimpanzee, man. I was not playing careful there at all.
I yield!
Wait, I don't.
It's over. This evil thing is clearly not working out for us, no matter how many skulls we slap onto ourselves.
Aww. Sorry to ruin your hopes and dreams, dude.
Any suggestions, then? I'm listening.
I don't know, just something else.
Like what?
Introspection would be a good start. What has all this brought us, really?
Ridiculous. I'm sticking to evil.
Oh, yeah? And how are you going to accomplish that? Anything if I'm not carrying you?
Well, I could. That's a good point, actually.
It's settled, then. Carry on, messenger. We promise not to cause the world any harm.
Okay. That was weird.
What, that's it?
Okay. Bye. What is the purpose of this? It's pretty cozy. I would sleep right here. Nobody would ever find you, because nobody else can climb walls. Bamboo Creek! Hey, this actually works out well, because this area doesn't have a boss. Yeah, that's right. This area actually doesn't have a boss. And I'm kind of spoiling it by saying that. Because we're not going to... What it does have is some slam dancing, some slam-tastic music. Y'all. This is a cool area. It's really satisfying to just run through here. Hey, El Mayo! Oh, great, it's story time. Bum, blop, blop, blop. Need anything? I can't afford this yet. I need 250 to get that. That's definitely the next upgrade I want, is prepared mind. Chat, current area. Bamboo Creek! That must be a sight for sore eyes after your trek in the catacombs. Sure is. Do make the best of it. This place is as close to a day off as you'll get on this adventure. I'll try, I just didn't know something so cheerful existed. I guess that says more about your mindset than about the world. Well, okay. About time shards. What are these crystals I'm collecting? So you're a touch the unidentified magic object first and ask questions later kind of guy? They're time shards. I can use them to augment your abilities. How does it work? Exactly the way we have been doing it so far. You select what you want and give me the required amount of shards so I can do my thing. I meant the spell itself. It's complicated. But I'm curious! And I'm busy. No, you're not! You have any stories to share? Of course I do, but now is not the time. Why not? You're in Bamboo Creek! This is as sunny as it gets in this here cursed world. So? So I suggest you take the opportunity to play outside. Bye now. But I want a story! Aww. Okay. Well, this might end up being kind of a short dick video then. Without any story time to pass the time. Yeah, I'm talking about passing the time while playing a video game. How depressing is that? I think right there, like that, if you see like a black gradient at the bottom of the screen, that means it is actually a pit. Because sometimes they'll hide secrets down there, like at the bottoms of pits. I love that, how you, like, when you swing the sword, you can turn around and actually, just like in Zelda 1, really. You can turn around mid-swing, and the sword swing continues in the opposite direction. Can you imagine how annoying that would have been to do if I couldn't destroy those fireballs? I'm telling you, man. Oh my god! That's gotta be the biggest Medusa head I've ever seen in my life. But now we got these things here. When you hit them, they go up, so you can cloud step to follow them up. Pretty fun, pretty cool stuff. Get out of here. Man, this song doesn't know where it's going. Holy cow. There we go. No, come on. You up? Oh my god, look at this. Chungus. What are you doing? Oh, he just fucked off? Okay, whatever. I guess he just fucked off. Who the hell was that? Some rando with a sword. Oh my god, it's a Pokey!
I want all the money that I can fit inside my pockets, and I'm not even gonna try to sing along with music anymore.
Not at that octave. Man, could I possibly be leaning any further forward when I'm running? I'm like leaning forward at like a 45 degree angle to the ground. It's like Charizard, man. You up? That didn't do anything. Oh, I think it just kept that gate open. Still nothing? I need one more shard to buy that upgrade. Hang on. Give me another shard. Thank you. Okay, let's go. Let's buy that upgrade. Jeez. Yeah, prepared mind. We'll upgrade our HP soon enough. But not yet. Because I'm enjoying getting these. Ah, no! No! First death in Bamboo Creek! Oh, a new customer. What? Who the fuck are you? What happened? I almost died just there.
Strictly speaking, you did.
Huh? But how?
My name's Quarble.
Quarble?
At your service. I'm the one you never would have met had you any skills.
Excuse the fuck you.
The gist of it is, I have a magic ring that allows me to control space and time. So whenever you are about to die, I will appear to stop everything and teleport you back to the latest checkpoint.
Okay, what's the catch?
Well, for one, you'll still feel agonizing pain every single time. Also, I'm keeping track of your debt in my little notepad, so I'll stick around to steal your loot until either we're even or I'm bored. I mean, I can let you die if you prefer. It seems we have a deal. Glad we see it eye to eye. Carry on, then.
Okay. Did he say eyes to eye there, maybe? And I just missed it? That would have been funny if he did. Anyway.
Yeah, so this is your death mechanic, basically.
Oh, I'm just supposed to duck there. Yeah. There you go. Whoa. No, come on. Oh, wait, I don't need to do that because I can just ride that thing up there. Go away, Quarble. I'm getting my money. Jeez. Yeah, so basically, every time you die, Quarble will follow you around for a while and eat your money. And it's really annoying. Thankfully, he actually, There are circumstances where he won't follow you around anymore, and he will eventually. Yeah, like see, there we actually just missed him. But when he actually is satisfied, he'll pull out his little notepad and jot something down to indicate that he is done. We missed it there because I scrolled him off screen. God, it's so happy here. It's like the happiest level in the world level. Woo! Man, this game feels so good to frickin' just run and slash. It should be called Run and Slash Man. The Run and Slasher. Running and slashing. Hey, Messenger, what are you doing? Oh, nothing, I'm just running and slashing. What are you gonna do next? I'm gonna run and I'm gonna run back and forth and I'm gonna jump and slash. Alright. Thankfully, that Quarble scene there probably afforded us a full-length episode here that we might not have otherwise gotten. Whoa! Okay. That was clumsy. Oh man, I can't wait to get to the next area. Because in the next area, jeez, we're gonna get the ability to attack down. Actually, we might not get that quite yet. That might be an upgrade we have to buy first. Hey, I see a secret down here. You can't run from me. Oh, jeez. Whoa! Oh, no. Thanks, you have accumulated 24 time shards so far. Yeah, he'll chime in like that every time you die. When you come back with only 3 health, too, I didn't mention that. That can be a little bit annoying. All things considered, I'm not surprised that this is the area where I first died, because this area has a lot of pits. Man, the recovery jump is so useful in this game. Like, most of the time when you have a move like that, you kind of forget that it exists, because it doesn't really... It's very, because it doesn't have a lot of presence. But in this game, it's like... It can save your life. Shit! Okay. Okay, so I want to do this when it's... Whew! That was close. You might actually want to do that while it's up, so that you can sneak underneath the spikes. I don't know, we got another seal, though. And thankfully, they open up like that, which makes it a little bit easier to backtrack. What's over here? Oh, is this the way forward? Oh, you're done? Okay. Good, fuck off. Stop eating my money. Stupid bank! Stop taking my money! Oh my god, name that LP. That's a pretty easy one, if you know. If you've seen it, you'll know, and you'll know instantly. Yeah, I think that's where we come back to where we were. I don't want to miss any of the money over here, you know. Ooh, that was close. Q up. Shit. No. Oh wait, you're supposed to ride this thing up. I always get confused here. Like even on my very first playthrough, I thought that like okay, up there must be like some kind of secret thing because of how hard it would be to get to like bounce off these guys' projectiles. But no, you just fall down and then you ride the platform up. Dude, oh my god, you guys are on amphetamines. Wait, I want that. Get out of here, you bitch. Oh, here we are, we're at the end of the place. And yeah, and like I said, oh wait, hang on, there's a secret down here. Yes. Money, 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 money. All right. That went adjective. We got our first deaths. Level boss. So I guess the boss is up next. A boss in Bamboo Creek. That's a good one. Well, with the layout, you know, perfectly centered gates, symmetrical lanterns, no scrolling. I just thought, look, you're perfectly free to hallucinate patterns and try to make sense of them. But I believe I told you this place was like your day off. So, well, would you fight a boss on your day off? Exactly. It's like, I love how, no, wait, I didn't mean to do that. But now's not the time, blah, 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 blah. Okay. I didn't mean to do that. I love how often the messenger cuts in with just an ellipses. It's like, something really funny about that. Anyway, yeah, there's no boss, just a pit. And I'm gonna get a whole bunch of money. Splish. You might have noticed there's actually an area on the... there was actually an opening on the right over there. We can't get over there yet. Too bad. Man, this is so cuck-a-feeling. I would so sleep here. Oh my god. I forgot how cool this is. The sound of the water just gradually, slowly, slowly fading away. Howling Grotto! I love how that even, like, it builds up your expectation more that there's gonna be a surprise boss, and then of course there isn't. Anyway, I guess we'll make our way into the Howling Grotto a bit, just until we find our next, checkpoint. Checkpoint! Yeah, here we go. Alright. Well, this is kind of an awkward place to end the episode, but we just did, we finished Bamboo Creek, and, you know what, I'm gonna get the upgrade first. I fell in a pit. I fell in the toilet. That you did. That gap is way too wide. There's no way I can make the jump. This reminds me of a story. A long time ago, warriors of the Squirrel Clan invented a way to soar through the skies. Touching on a freedom humans could seldom dream of, someone would mistake them for gods. Incredible. Yeah, whatever. Here's a wingsuit. Hey, we got it. Press an old A old airborne to glide. Deploy over geysers to fly upwards. Need anything? Can I buy any upgrades? I can buy this. Wingsuit attack? Oh, yeah. I definitely want that. So with the wingsuit, we can, float down like that. It doesn't slow your descent by a ton. Like, as you can see, we pretty much fall at a 45-degree angle. But, that's better than what we were doing before. And with the wingsuit upgrade, the aerobatics warrior, we can even attack down while we're doing it, which is extremely useful. Lets us attack from below, get a cloud step, and it even propels you upward when you hit an enemy too. So you can like pogo. We can basically pogo now. But we're gonna have to show off how effective that is and take on the. Oh my god, I'm so bad at outros. That's gonna be it for this episode of The Messenger. Next time on The Messenger, we're gonna take on the Howling Grotto with our brand new wingsuit. So, bye, and I'll see you next time. Snap. Oh, come on, get a finger snap.